JDC West. Let me give you a little bit of a backstory before I get into how I got into it this year. So, I was an incoming first year. Oh my gosh, that was like 3 years ago at this point. That's so crazy to say. But I was approached to do the athletics for JDC West in my first year. And at that point, they were doing some like pretty weird sports. It was like kickball, baseball, and some sort of like Quidditch thing. And I wasn't really into it. But at the same time, they were hiring. They were also doing hiring for the social team as well as the debate team. And social team, I don't think I'm out there enough to be willing to do the social team. I don't really want to dress in a dress. If I have the picture of Eric in a dress at school, I'm gonna put that there. But that was my first impression of the social team at JDC West. So yeah, and then debate, I'm a decent debater, but I know there's people who are way better at debating than me, and there's no way I could ever represent my entire school in debate. So that was completely out of the realm of possibility, and I was really just not into doing JDC West. Little did I know, and I only found out about this year, JDC West also has academics. Wow, mind-blowing, right? The problem is they do their hiring during the summer, but I wasn't at Sauder before I came into school as a first year in September, so I didn't know they had academics or case comps. So fast forward to fourth year, I'm still not entirely interested in JDC West because at this point I only think there's weird athletic sports, social challenges and debate, all of which I wasn't really interested in. So I just didn't think to do JDC West. And then I was just chilling at the library with one of my friends, and then what do you know, Zachary Goldthorpe and Lydia Yoon, the two co-captains of JDC West this year, come up to my friend and they're like, hey, do you know anyone who's either athletic or tall or knows volleyball? And my friend was like, yeah, this person over here, introducing Matt. And I was like, hi, hello. Yeah, I do volleyball in my spare time. I'm sort of good. And then they were like, oh, that's crazy. Are you tall? Can you stand up for us? And this is like in the middle of like a silent library. And I was like, you want me to like stand up like right now? And they're like, yeah, we need you to stand up. And I was like, okay. And so I stood up for them and they're like, you're perfect. Can we have you for JDC West? And I was like, you guys are doing volleyball for JDC West? That's the most normal sport I've ever heard of for JDC West. But then, isn't there two sports? Like, surely the second JDC West sport is gonna be weird, right? And they're like, oh no, it's dodgeball. And I was like, oh, that's a wrap. That's a wrap. We're definitely signing up for JDC West. And so your boy decided to try out for JDC West. And tryouts was absolutely amazing. We had three tryouts, each 3 hours long. And I would just equate it to like summer camp. We just played dodgeball and volleyball with like all of our closest friends for 3 hours, like three times in a single week. It was probably one of the best experiences of my fourth year up until that point, which doesn't really say much because this was only a week into fourth year, but still, you get the point. I didn't vlog any of the tryouts because how funny would it be if I did vlog the tryouts and I didn't make the team? But I made the team, so I'm so happy to be bringing you guys on this amazing journey. We're gonna have so much fun. This video is gonna be all of the best, funniest memories, and it's gonna be an absolute blast. But first things first, let's go meet the athletics team who we're about to spend way too much time with.
No. Okay, I'll demonstrate, okay. Herman Zhang, 6'4", University of Michigan commit, and my fun fact is I can do a handstand.
They call me Woo Back Wednesday. I'm not twerking for this.
Hi, I'm Josh, and I can dunk a very small dodgeball.
My name is Carson, and I can dunk better than Josh.
I have one.
All right, go.
Hi, I'm Christina, and I can sneeze with my eyes open.
Are you gonna dunk here or no?
Go.
Okay, I need a tissue. I'll send video proof.
Hi, I'm Izzy. I'm 10'5", and I have diabetes.
Hi, I'm Matt. I'm 6'7", and I can't dunk.
Thank you.
What can you do?
Make banana bread.
Hi, my name is Kate. Do you have any games on your phone? Do you have any games on your phone? Do you have any games on your phone?
Yeah.
Please note that this video is an inaccurate representation of Kate. She actually is very tall and knows how to drive.
Awesome, so that's the team. As you can tell, we're all very tall, very athletic, and very attractive. So real quick, let me just explain to you if you don't know what JDC West is. So JDC West stands for Jeux de Commerce West. So there's just the Commerce Games and we're like on the West Coast, so we call it the West Side. There's like also the Central Side, which is like Ontario and more eastwards, but it's more lame from what I hear. JDC West is the better side, so that's really the side you want to be on. So it doesn't really make sense to go to any university that's east in or in Ontario. So yeah, Ontario universities suck. Anyways, back to JDC West. Basically what it is every commerce or business school from like the western half of Canada puts together a JDC West team. And as I said before, the teams consist of some academics case competition peoples. So we have like different disciplines such as like not-for-profit, entrepreneurship, business tech management, and so forth. And those are all case competition teams. Then there's the athletics team, which has 8 of us, plus the 4 master debaters for the debate discipline. And lastly, we have the 4 social team members. And the best way I can explain what the social team does is the Amazing Race. I don't really know how else to describe it, but the Amazing Race. You'll probably see some of what goes on later in this video, but that's all I'm gonna say for now. And so that is JDC West in a nutshell. So for the next 4 months, we're basically gonna be practicing all throughout this semester. For athletics people, that means doing volleyball practices, dodgeball practices, as well as playing in the volleyball and dodgeball intramurals. So that means a ton of sports going on. For the academics, debates, and social team, they're just gonna be doing like case competition stuff, debate stuff, and social challenges stuff. I don't wanna bore you by showing you all the footage there is, but here's a few clips to show you what goes on at our athletics practices.
Is it me?
So here we're actually scrimmaging against ourselves 4v4. Izzy off the running start, beats Josh out to both balls. Aw, sad boy Josh. Maybe next time, buddy. Alright, Izzy up first. Bow! Bow! And then she gets me out immediately. Look at my sad shot, bro. So sad, man. Alright, up next I think we have Kate. She spikes the first ball here into the ground and then gets pressed down on the second ball. Absolutely insane. No weak links on the team. And then I think immediately after, Kate gets Herman out. Wow, absolutely insane. Next clip up, we got Herman with an absolute rocket. Ah! Ooh! And then we got Josh trying to give me the head rob. Ooh, ooh, ah! And then ah! Oh! Aww. And then to end off the round, we got the most nonchalant catch by Izzy. And then here's us playing some actual intramurals against, I think it's a frat team. But I'll let Izzy commentate this one.
Okay, get back, get back. It's currently 3-on-5. Score is 5-0. The date is November 2nd.
Good documentation.
2021. Oh yeah,
waiting
there's
for
Christina.
Something historical to happen.
Oh yeah, I'm waiting for a Matrix kind of move. Oh, good try, Matt.
Oh yeah.
Look at him go. Big man Josh, let's go.
Carson hasn't shown up to practice, so we're bullying him, and we're doing a 5v1. Oh, we all got out. Carson versus Izzy. 1v1. Good job, buddy. And then just the way that our intramural schedule worked out, we had dodgeball and volleyball on the same day every single week. So we were all extremely exhausted by taking the volleyball. Oop, never mind. It looks like Josh is still feeling good.
Get that.
Now that we met the athletics team, let's go drop in on the social team and see what the practices are all about. First, we'll go for a run. Please excuse me being out of breath. And then secondly, the coaches prepared a bunch of PowerPoints, so the social team will be presenting them blindly, and we can see some of their improv.
Here.
I'm
just gonna go down to the cycle, and then down to the curtain pull, and then back.
Oh,
it's 2K. Three times. Oh, 6. Are we good?
We're back?
Huh? What is this? Look at the four of us all running. Or the four of them. Wow.
And that's why I'm introducing to you how to solve this pain physically. Our idea focuses on the lower back, and it kind of resolves this idea in your head where you can have this photography idea suspended by your back and on the top of your head. So instead of being secretly filmed,
12.
Stop it. How do you have that much storage? Because I have a proposition and I am so excited to share it with all of you. It is going to be fun-filled and fun-packed. Mugs. You know, you're walking through, you're zooming out in the mornings, and you just, sometimes, you just, boom, you knock over your mug. But look no further. We have paw mugs now. And instead of one vase, we're starting with all four. You can take it with you everywhere, and it'll be your new favorite cup in the morning, at night, or whenever you miss your cup. Woo!
Woo! You should have called it the pup cup.
Every time I go to a concert, I am amazed. Not by the people, not by the imagery of the concert, but by that one thing that a celebrity is holding. Now, what do you think that celebrity is holding? Well, to focus on in, I want to show you this product, which is the snot. The snot that comes out of your very mouth. In every concert, in every radio station that you hear, achoo, achoo. Every time I see a celebrity at a concert do this, I understand that, hey, I don't actually like it.
And here is our new revolutionary product where McNuggets from McDonald's, they're best served hot. An entire night can go by and like eat them when they're cold. Disgusting. This way, you can you can put them in the little sleeves there. You can put them in the sleeves there, and then you can go to the nightclub and eat it as you go. Chicken Little, he loves it. You imagine, look at the tenderness of those thighs. Oh, my mouth is watering thinking about it. And power, no one says it just has to be chicken either. You can fill it with any product you want. And it just keeps going, because it's not going to switch.
This set of slides is the best one.
I don't think that's
this fit you, fit you so well.
Now that we met most of the JDC West team, let's go make those connections even deeper. And what better way to do that than by taking the entire team, dropping them off in the middle of nowhere in some deep dark forest somewhere, and forcing them to talk about their deepest, darkest traumas. Hey, that's exactly what we're doing this weekend. There's gonna be way too much going on, so instead of trying to vlog it, I'm gonna make a cute little cinematic video and play it for you guys. Ayo, cue the cinematics.
People want to get wet, they will get wet.
In the video, you can see that we had a big piece of canvas and we put all of our handprints on it in hand paint, and that was so cool. We actually ended up cutting it up into like little squares, and so each person has one of the little pieces of the canvas, and we all wrote little cute messages to each other. Look how cute it is. Reading it makes me so like happy, sad, just all the cute messages. Aww. Although I must say, writing on canvas is really hard, and there's one of these messages here. It's like a really big paragraph, and the paragraph says, Matt. And the rest is unreadable, and then the bottom of it says, from Sang. That makes me so sad, because I'll never know what she said. But I had such an amazing time. It was one of the best weekends ever. As much as I would love to say that JDC West is all about us, the competitors, and winning, it's really not. We also try to give back to the community, and one way we're doing that is by raising money for BC Cancer Research. So all the competitors and the executives all have their own fundraiser, and whoever raises the most money gets like all the brag rights at the end of the season. Another way we're trying to give back to the community is by volunteering. So there's a bunch of volunteering opportunities spread out throughout the season, but tonight we're actually going to go to the Vancouver Whitecaps game, where we will be volunteering with the Covenant House, and so we'll be raising money for children in need. And so it's just a really great time hanging out with friends and putting our efforts towards a good cause. And of course, we'll always end off our nights with a great dinner. So you already know it's going to be a fun time.
Sorry.
So right now we're at the Whitecaps game. It's hockey, yeah.
Relax. Wait, film the sign right behind your shoulder.
Six people.
Yeah. What?
Oh, okay. We fit the whole team in!
Hello?
Get your 50-50 here! 50-50!
$4,860 grand prize and climbing.
Yeah.
Yo, let's go!
I should stop doing that.
Yay! Yay.
Okay, round number two. This time we're gonna do it without standing, so hopefully the waiter doesn't yell at us. So let's do it. Here we go.
Alright. 3, 2, go.
I beat Matt.
No, no. This guy should stop, and we are sitting down. Anyways, run it back. Run it back. Round three. We'll do it later when we're not at an Earl's.
Oh, weird.
What? Did you call me weird?
You look like
weird.
No, they're
Earl's is low key bad.
What?
What was that?
What?
Sorry, did you lose a chunk?
Hey, you lost a chunk.
You lost one too, buddy.
Halloween social.
1-1.
Halloween social, let's go.
Wrong hand, but it's okay because I'm holding up the camera with the other one.
Another really cool part about JDC West is that we get to do volleyball tournaments on top of our practices. So today is one of our practice days. We're here at Richmond Olympic Oval and we're in a volleyball tournament. We got Izzy here. We have Josh off doing a captain's meeting because he's an important captain.
No,
but
he went to the bathroom,
okay, never mind. But
yeah. So if you didn't notice, the rest of the team's not here, and that is because Carson isn't picking up his phone because Hannah's trying to pick him up and drive him here. So as of right now, we have three people here trying to field a six-person volleyball team. Pray for us.
Captain's meeting is happening right now. It's about time to start. We have Kat, who is our social sub. Welcome to the team. Woo! Ready to have us win. And but yeah, no, it's just the four of us now, so we're missing players. I believe we're allowed to have one ghost, so we're still one person short. All right, we have two?
No, we're allowed to have two ghosts.
Wow.
At the last minute, Hannah showed up, so did Spencer, and also our coach Evan down there. Evan's gonna set. So we have enough people, thank gosh.
Yay!
Woo! We got to field the team!
Thank you.
game.
Hey.
Hey. Chris, how do you feel?
Tired.
How do you feel, Matt?
Excited that we won.
How do you feel, JM?
Proud.
How do you feel?
Amazing.
How do you feel, Evan?
Tired.
How do you feel, Spencer?
I don't know. Pretty scraped up, but.
How do you feel, Carson?
Who?
How do you feel, Carson?
Oh, I feel great. Honestly, it was a great tournament.
Yeah.
I showed up halfway through.
Yeah.
But we ended up winning.
Prairie fire. Prairie fire.
Prairie fire.
Prairie
fire. Obviously. How do you feel, Hannah?
I feel really good.
Yeah.
Yo, we get served.
And Subway.
And Subway.
Woo!
I'm so hungry right now.
Are you in the tournament?
That's it.
Already?
Already.
Damn, I felt like time flew by.
Time flew by.
We had so much fun playing in this tournament, but that is going to conclude part number one of the JDC West saga at UBC Sauder. There is still so much more JDC West content coming your way, so make sure you subscribe and stay tuned, and ooh, I cannot wait for you guys to see the rest of the things that we did. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Welcome back to the channel. If you guys didn't catch part number one of the JDC saga, make sure you do that first to get all caught up on all the memories and fun stuff that's been going on already. But we ended off last video with doing our sim for volleyball, which ended up being a volleyball tournament, which was so fun. But today we're going to do dodgeball, and we're going to play a sim, a full tournament style, against our coaches and our coaches' friends. And it's going to be an absolute blast. So let's head off to the gym and get this video started.
Sim, got the entire academic team showing up, and yeah, we're gonna play a sim against the coaches over there. Yee.
Gonna give a little bit of a commentary here. First game of the day, everyone's going off, firing on all cylinders. JM gets me with a huge dodge here, but it doesn't even matter because I sailed the ball way over him anyways, and then like an idiot, I'm turning away as he gets me out. What the hell, man. Later in that game, it ended up being down to Christina and Hannah versus our coach JM, and Christina comes up with a massive catch to seal the win for our first game of our sim. Second game, it looks like Josh gets tagged on the toe, and it's 1-1. Next game starts off pretty strong, but very quickly it starts going downhill for us. It's just Kate, Christina, and Hannah left, and there goes Kate, there goes Christina, and it's just up to Hannah now. Although, Hannah does mount a pretty sick comeback here. But in the end, it looks like we lost to a little toe tap here. Next game we came out firing though, here's Josh and I with that spicy teamwork. Speaking of teamwork though, here's Josh and I with the 1-2-1 combo. Woo! Ah! Jeez! Oh my goodness. On the other hand, we got Herman trying to be way too cute with it. Like, bro, you're already cute enough as it is. It's not like you need to try to be cute. Nearing the end of the game now, it's like one me versus four of them, but at least you get Evan out here. But then here's part like 10 of me being stupid. Why am I turning away here? Okay, you know what? We're gonna come back strong next game. Look at all of us firing away, trying to get Evan, the last one out. Oh my gosh, this guy almost breaks his freaking ankle. Okay, we're on defense now. I'm gonna learn from my mistake. I'm gonna face the ball and not turn away. I'm gonna catch the ball and oh my fucking gosh, I just got domed by Evan. Thankfully, Kate gets him out and we finally walk away with a win. Here you'll see one of our better openings. Carson, Josh, and I fire straight from the jump and we get three hits straight away. I think JM blocked my ball, but that's besides the point. Zachary Goldthorpe with the shot! Yeah.
Damn, I know I said I like five guys, but I don't think I can take them all at once. Okay, get wrecked. And then one more for the team. Well, that sort of sucked. By the end of the day, we were getting beat, and we were getting beat badly and consistently. I wrote down a bunch of excuses as to why that happened, but honestly, I think it's just because I suck at dodgeball. So I better get better by the end of the season, because that was pretty bad and that was pretty embarrassing. But anyways, once our sim wrapped up and once all the academic sims wrapped up, we all headed back to Sauder, where we worked on our intro skit. But I'll let Izzy talk more about that.
All right, what are we doing today?
We're doing our skit practice, and we're learning all the dances. The Katy Perry dance is super cool. Katy Perry dance is so good. We got Roar going on over there. We just learned, what was it, California Girls. We got some Get Your Freak On with Missy Elliott. We also have Teenage Dream, and the big fireworks at the end. It's so good. Stay tuned.
Oh, shit. That sounded scary. It's alright.
Oh my gosh. Anyways, back to the main event.
Okay.
Greetings, though. Okay.
So as part of the Katy Perry dance, Lydia and Zach actually sourced shark costumes for me to wear.
Wow.
Just the head.
So do I just step into it?
Yeah. Oh my god.
Oh, there's like...
Oh!
Whoa! Okay.
Oh!
Whoa.
Oh
my god, the moment of truth.
You got flippers.
Whoa. No way.
No.
I'm a shark.
No. Put the head on.
It's pretty short, but it works.
But you can't see that. Are you good?
Can't see, maybe, but we might go for like, yeah, I'm so social.
Wow. Can you breathe?
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah.
Start dying.
I think we're
doing it. Wait, you have to inflate it.
It is inflated. Oh my god! Wait, let's go out, let's go out!
What guy? A
twerk!
Twerk,
twerk!
Twerk, twerk!
Hey, you should get dunked in that.
Yeah, you should get dunked.
Wait, no, please
stop. Also, there's batteries.
Yeah, once you get electrocuted.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
All right.
Okay,
so we sort of finished wrapping up practicing our dance a little bit early. So Herman decided to break out some mats and work on his acrobatics, and that will be the footage that follows.
I used to get used to that, I guess.
Are you guys learning that headstand?
Yeah.
No.
Does anyone know how to do a flip?
No, the cushions are good.
Yeah,
like
send it.
Send it.
Send it. Go, Matt. Go, Matt. Hype him up. Hype him up.
Let's go, Matt. Let's go. Okay,
go, 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 go. Get him. Oh, that was good. We were trying to do a front flip. I was going to do a back flip, but that's a terrible idea. And then tap.
Okay. Oh. Are you okay?
Do not worry.
Are you filming?
Why are we doing
this? What? Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god! Nice.
Yo, chill. I'm taking this out of the vlog.
What?
JDC, I have your attention for a second. We're going to wrap up the night. Just have a closing, few closing remarks for Skit. Awesome. Thank you everyone who got involved, whether you're just in firework, you're part of the Roar Squad, the California Girls Squad, really appreciate the energy.
And then just as Christian was wrapping up, Herman's like, hey yo, Matt wants to show you guys something. He's gonna do a flip.
Stop.
Get him, get him.
Wait, wait, wait.
Stop watching.
Just close your eyes and you'll see it.
Close your eyes.
Wait, I don't know how to film this.
Not to be the fourth.
You stop at green and go at red. What am I?
No.
Oh, roundest fruit, yes.
Roundest fruit.
Pico produce does not include watermelon sold separately.
Hi everyone, I'm Carissa and I'm Sauder JDC West's VP Charity and Outreach. Today we are out here braving the cold with our dunk tank. Today we're raising money for the BC Cancer Foundation and every dollar is triple matched and everything goes towards advancing BC cancer research for our patients here.
Captain on captain of islands. Someone timing? No.
Someone's gotta add ice.
Alright, next up is Allison.
How much can we pay for move the wetsuit?
Zach! What? Too far?
Wait, let's do it. Let's do it. Out of my air. Can you get out of my shot?
Sorry.
What is that? Whoa!
One time.
You have the video on that. Oh! That was so soon. Whoa!
Yeah. Oops, I slipped and I fell.
Give me a frisbee, I'll hit 3 for 3.
Come on!
They ask you how you are, you just have to say that you're fine when you're not really fine, but you just can't get into it because.
This guy's okay. Throwing it from all the way over. Okay.
I apologize.
Nope.
Oh, that went so high over. Izzy! Izzy's 2 for 2! Oh, Kenny. Hold.
Alright, freeze throw for Hannah.
Yay. We dunked Christina like 30 times. That's so fun. Definitely worth it. Oh my gosh.
Matt, let's go.
All right, my time up to go. Got the Steve Irwin outfit. Let's get in there.
I thought they'd keep me warm. But also, I don't want you guys getting free feet picks, you know?
I want free
feet. My feet picks are $20 each. Hey, if you guys give me more money, I will take the donations for feet pics.
Why are you wearing pants?
Cause I thought we were all wearing nice Halloween costumes. The hell, you guys?
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah, yo, look at me, I'm all dressed up, and all these guys, these guys are wearing wetsuits. That's cheating.
No, I wear onesies.
Oh no, Allison. I'm so cold, just like sitting up here.
Oh, okay, here we go. Oh, that was nope.
Oh, this one's for Bree, our coach. Thank you, Bree. Oh. Hey, you guys suck. Hurry up. If you don't make this, you're cut. Oh, a shame.
I'm so cold. Not the khakis. Oh, I'm so cold. This is the worst part, just like sitting up here waiting for these guys to get another toss. Cause now I'm cold and I'm out of the water. Hurry up! You're trash, Herman. Oh, sorry if this footage is a little shaky. My hands are so cold and I'm shivering.
Oh my god, it's so cold.
Wait, from who?
From athletics.
Oh,
Christina.
Thanks, Christina. Yay. That's payback because I paid $25 to dunk Christina for 3 minutes. Oh, it's so cold. It's a good thing Christina can't throw though.
Watch him explain his GoPro as he falls into the water.
He is savage. Go get him, Christina! Yeah!
Oh, this little scream before he goes in.
Dun 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 dun. That's why he can't catch her throws. Dun 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 dun.
Maybe you guys are wearing socks.
Okay, shall I come around?
Oh my gosh.
This Herman guy has been on fire with these balls, but he sucks at dodgeball. What happened? Kenny got three throws for me. So thank you, Kenny. And thank you, Bree. And I think Kelly also did three throws. So thanks, Kelly. Thanks, Kenny. And thanks, Bree. Why are you so close?
Really?
So it's the last minute, thank gosh. I'm down to go home. Oh.
That was throws from Kenny. On behalf.
Wow, I can't even talk. That was throws from Allison on behalf of Kenny. So thanks, Kenny. Allison, you did a good job.
Oh, dude.
What? Yeah, I'm done. Oh, okay. My time's up. You can't talk to me anymore. Okay, we're all done. I'm gonna go inside, get dry. I'm so cold, but
It's all good because it's for charity. Woo, charity! Okay, let's go watch.
It's for charity.
Okay, let's go watch other people get dunked because I've had enough.
I sprinted back to see Spencer getting dunked. Oh, good timing.
Oh, okay.
My God,
I think the writing was so perfect. That was okay.
Okay, here you go, Carson.
I really got it. Nope.
Oh, what?
Every time. Okay.
Oh, he's been in there.
It's so funny when he drops.
Oh, Carissa.
Am I done? You're done.
Woo! Yeah, Carson. Oh, no, Zachy boy.
Look at that. I made a nice little pattern.
Should I show off my pouch?
Sure.
Your pregnant pouch.
My pregnant pouch. Hi everyone, it's the end of the day and look how much money we raised. I think we've almost raised $3,000 just today, so it's really awesome. And it'll be triple match, so $9,000 for BC Cancer. Yay!
Yesterday's Chillin For Charity event was an absolute success. We raised so much money and had such a fun time while doing it. So tonight, we're gonna go and celebrate. Got the Steve Irwin fit all washed up, ready to go because I wasn't wearing a wetsuit like some others were yesterday. But Kathy invited us all over to her place. So we're gonna have a little party. We're gonna celebrate our massive achievement and all the money we raised for cancer research. And just have a great time with all the folks. A drunk Matt might appear later in this video, so apologies in advance. But let's go celebrate!
Relax yourself.
I guess I'm filming it.
Yo. Wait, we're doing it right now? I just got here.
Do you want to do it now or do you want to drink first?
Let's do it later.
Later?
Later? What do you mean? No.
You have delaying it? I have to choose it now on this day.
Yo, there's no one here, dog.
You have to blow, you could also finger. Both fingers are lost.
Alright, so Kathy and I were doing the thing where it's has to donate $100, so it's 1-1 right now as of the last charity. Here's the last one. Side note, if Kenny wins, then I have to donate 100 chill. But if I donate 100 chill, then...
Alright.
But if I donate 100 to him, yes, he's over $1,000. It's over $1,000.
He would be over $1,000.
I don't want to get over $1,000.
And then I want
that toy today. Honestly, like, I'm sorry. I want you to win.
What do you do for charity?
The winner's charity account. It all comes down to this.
I'm gonna get my split shorts. I don't know why I said this. Every day for 7 days, and that includes everything I do. Classes, meetings, dates.
Dates? You'll go on dates?
You don't know about that yet.
Alright, I need video footage of this.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, let me go pee first. I'll be back.
Oh. This boy's nervous. This boy's nervous.
Oh, as soon as the glass plate came on.
Now,
girls. All right.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Go.
I tried my best! I'm so
told you the first. That's why I didn't want to.
Oh, okay, Allison.
Oh, that's so dangerous.
Cheers, lad.
Cut your hand, bro.
Won't touch it.
What's going on? Cheers.
What the fuck? Okay, 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay. Okay.
Oh, holy shit, you're done. You're fucked.
That's fucked.
Allison, what the fuck is that?
That's not like a chug, but you're fucked.
Allison, why are you still going?
You have to catch up.
Sorry, daddy? What? Sorry, daddy? Sorry.
Sorry, daddy?
Hey, you guys are late. You guys are late.
Is it? Over 1,000? Oh, he's over 1,000!
Patrick and Matt are really excited that I am.
Split shorts, baby?
Split shorts?
Split shorts?
You never liked my post.
I love your post.
Exposed.
Gangnam Style in the fucking fountain? Open Gangnam Style.
Woo! Split shorts, baby! Let's go! Yeah, for the vlog. Yo, we're trying to leave, but all these people.
Shut the fuck up when you leave right now!
You're
shut
not doing up. That, though! Suddenly, I'm also.
Oh my fucking gosh. JDC is an actual mess.
Let's go!
Oh my fucking god, bro!
Are you guys good? Are you good, Sean?
I like your butt.
Thanks, bro.
Oh, sorry.
Alright, we're on our way to the calendar party. Like, we just went to like the pre.
Yo,
now we're on his calendar. Can we just like keep walking instead of like stopping?
No, we will walk.
Okay, anyways, Spencer is absolutely fried. He's got a box of pizza.
I'm not fried at all. I'm the one guiding people.
Plus, he's got all my alcohol in a drawstring bag. I don't know what he's doing with it, but he just said he wanted it. So I'm letting him have it.
Okay, then we're good.
What a lovely person.
Can you
bring your camera to the fucking party?
I am, dog. It's gonna be a fucking wild time. We gotta capture all the JDC moments, you know?
How are you doing that?
Matt, how are you gonna get this bag? How are you gonna get this bag in there?
Bro, I told you to leave it with Kathy. Why'd you take it from me?
You told me to take it.
No, I did. I told you to give it to Kathy.
Yo.
No, I told you to give the bag to Kathy, bro.
That is not what you said.
Give it
that
to
is not
go,
what you
go
said.
Back. Give it to Kathy.
I'm not going back.
What are you doing? Bro,
you gotta drink it.
What? There's so many bottles in there.
There's two.
There's at least three. There's at least three bottles in there, bro.
You're gonna drink at least three bottles.
Bro, go get it back.
That's a hell of a walk.
Can we go right?
Spencer, I'll take you home if you don't want to.
I don't know.
Are we late or are we early?
I think half of them
we're late.
Early.
Okay.
So we're
guys,
do you want to be in here? This is Mandy.
I'm not in JDC, but I'm cool. Hi.
Wow.
You're basically JDC at this point.
Yeah.
I don't know what the fuck drinks are.
Do you want more drinks?
JDC! I'm literally 5 inches shorter than that.
Tickets, oh my gosh. I got tickets. Allison got tickets. We got so many tickets, oh my gosh. Yes, Kat.
Yes, and I think we had a great time at the calendar party last night.
Yes, and I swear, right when I walked in, it was crazy to see Kenny go dancing.
Yeah, and I swear he was with some girl, like...
Yes, and the girl definitely looked like she wasn't his type.
Yes, and I really saw that, you know, suddenly something just hit me in the face.
Yes, and then I realized he didn't, that it wasn't actually a costume and it was actually a dude.
Yes, and Kenny tried to play it off so fast, but he still wanted to be really respectful towards the person.
Yeah, and I swear, like, they were about to go to her room or his room, but then Kenny said...
Yes, and he definitely said yes to the consent, but the dude slash girl opened their pants.
Yeah. Yes, and then I realized something really, really big. Like, his dick.
Yes, and then I grabbed Kenny, pulled him out of the porta potty, and we went back to the dance floor.
Yes, and after that, Kenny made sure to look really closely, even though it was dark, if it was a costume or just them being themselves.
Yeah, and then I remember eating a crap ton of Subway, and I ended up making out with Spencer.
No! Yes! I'm not the only one who loves to play with it.
For context, Matt, during Sim, we couldn't figure out this riddle, and it's like Spencer's comfort zone. He's like, go scream.
Wait, tell me what the riddle is, see if I can get it.
Oh.
Go at red and stop at green.
Go at red and stop at green.
What am I?
Wait, go at red and stop at green?
Yeah.
I'm gonna say a watermelon?
Yes! He fucking knew the
answer. He's a soldier.
I should fucking spot this.
Someone told
him. Oh, we were talking about it?
I did it at the bar with you guys.
Yeah.
That's why you hit.
I'm gonna guess watermelon?
Instantly. What is my mind code? Instantly, it makes me think of water. Fuck off.
Yo, I got them. They fell for it.
just say the riddle. I don't even know.
I've been using my ruler in the classroom.
Been using to measure things in the classroom.
No, if you got right.
Wait, I have to rhyme with ruler?
Yeah.
That is hard.
That's what I said.
We all say in the classroom.
Yeah, okay.
I'm cooler than everyone in the classroom.
Okay, new one.
I've been looking cooler in the classroom.
Yeah.
I've been wearing my hat in the classroom.
Love getting some pats in the classroom.
I've been looking at his cat in the classroom.
I be fucking with that chat in the classroom.
What?
There was a goddamn rat in the classroom.
Oh shit, back up, use your tats in the classroom.
My name is Matt in the classroom.
What the fuck is this Nat doing in the classroom?
No, you mean what the fuck is that in the classroom?
The fuck is in frats in the classroom?
I'm in the back in the classroom.
That shit is whack in the classroom.
I think Matt meant bat in the classroom.
Nah, it's more like tack in the classroom.
I might give you a smack in the classroom.
Fuck it, we're using slack in the classroom.
A girl had a fat rack in the classroom.
Building stacks on stacks in the classroom.
That girl cute, I want a Mac in the classroom.
Computer class, I might hack in the classroom.
Trying to get her in the sack.
Trying to get her with the pack in the classroom.
I might just go on attack in the classroom.
I used that.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, it's
like
attack.
She did.
She's on, I'm on. I got a lot of class in the classroom.
I got tons of ass in the classroom.
I be going to mass in the classroom.
I be spitting them facts in the classroom.
Oh, that's what I was gonna say too. I be giving the teacher hella sass in the classroom.
I'm so fat, I got mass in the classroom.
I be smoking that grass in the classroom.
That bitch looking kind of flat in the classroom.
Smoking that puff puff pass in the classroom.
Yo, that shit, that wacky ass style, that's crass in the classroom.
Okay, fuck that one.
If you're not first, you're last in the classroom.
Floor it in my car, use a lot of gas in the classroom.
All right.
I grabbed
this. This is so fun.
You switch it every time you do it different.
Going fishing in the class, it's a bass in the washer.
Bass
in the
Yo.
Spencer can't think of anything, so we pass in the classroom.
She already said pass.
No, I said pass. Oh. Puff, puff, pass.
Puff, puff, pass. Dude, Matt is like on fire.
New rhyme then.
Yeah, do new rhyme.
Doggo?
Literally anything.
Just, you're starting, that's the easiest part.
Purple! I'd be looking at you in the classroom.
I don't know what you're trying to do in the classroom.
I'm trying to get with you in the classroom.
I just said you.
Oh, I heard.
I said you.
Yeah.
I'm trying to fuck up SFU in the classroom.
I
will
be hooking up with Mary Lou in the classroom.
Whoa.
I be trying to make her go move.
Wow, it's always so fun going to the Sochie's practices. It's always a great burst of energy and I get to practice my bars. That's the end of this video. And smash that like button. Like, subscribe, do whatever you want. Follow my car account, Matt Chin with the one. Follow my Instagram, Matt Chin with the X. And follow my Twitter for really shitty memes and tweets. And I'll catch you in the next video, part 3.
Welcome back to the channel. We're now on part 3 of the JDC West journey at UBC Sauder. If you guys didn't catch parts number 1 and 2, make sure you go watch those first so you can get all caught up to speed on the crazy shenanigans and the fun memories that we've already made. But today, we're gonna go be filming our intro video. I'm not entirely sure what that's for, but I was just told to bring some buckets and my nice smile, and we're gonna be filming some stuff. So let's get right into it and let's get on with today's video. Got the whole team here. We're doing something, filming. We got the green screen. But we were told to bring buckets, so I brought like 8 big ass buckets. So we got buckets here, and this guy's also a bucket. Every time he plays basketball, just straight buckets. And then we also got more buckets, because buckets on buckets.
Christina took the last slice of pizza. Big sad. I'll leave her Instagram right here so you can leave hate comments on it.
Okay.
You know, have you watched the Gladiator?
I watched
the YouTube
video that day.
Yeah, so. What else?
We're all getting dressed dodgeball. In our togas.
Okay, we're taking dodgeball.
Wait.
How's it looking, dog?
Okay, wait.
Impeccable.
Impeccable.
Can I get a she? Can I get a sheesh?
Sheesh!
Go. Go. Walk. Go.
Is this another Toy Story walk up the bathroom kind of vibe?
Wow.
It's almost worked.
Put this perfect. On, too heavy. Put this on your other, like, my minor neck.
It's gonna choke him.
It can cover your face, and at times you can lift them above. So it's like a, kind of like a couple of legs.
This is like actually
gonna kill my you, and then it goes down. Cause you guys should be bouncing up and down on those chairs, right? Your team's over here first. Come over here.
And yeah. 3, 2, 1.
Yeah. Okay, great. That was fantastic.
I want to
maybe like go.
She is, but it's on camera.
Wait,
that's part of the scene.
Here's line.
Get them!
And ball.
Rules.
Goodbye, Tom.
Oh no, my beautiful hair! Fantastic take. And I want you to like, one of you go to like, close and kiss it. And then after that, I want you to reveal the entire brand. Action!
Yeah!
Yes!
I just got back from practice and I'm feeling so exhausted, but also so good and so excited because in 1 week we're off to the West Coast Games. The West Coast Games is like a mini tournament with all of the teams from British Columbia. So this is the first time we get to see like how well we stack up against them, and also the first time we get to play with like actual JDC rules. So I'm so excited and I can't wait, and I'll see you guys at the West Coast Games. So yeah, that happened. Literally 2 days before West Coast Games, your boy took a knee to the back of the neck and got sent to the hospital for the night. And oh my gosh, that was so painful. But I think what's even more painful is that it had to happen like at that time, because we were in the middle of like our playoff run for Intramurals, so I was out for the rest of the playoffs, and it just had to happen right before West Coast Games, so I had to miss West Coast Games. And oh, it's just so frustrating, because I was looking forward to playing West Coast Games so freaking badly, and I didn't get to play. So yeah, that's just frustrating and upsetting, and just wow, what unlucky timing and bad luck, and yeah, frick man, like come on. But I guess that's just what happens when you play at sort of a competitive level. No one wants to let the team down, or I guess the ball down for that matter. But yeah, wow, is that ever frustrating and saddening and upsetting. But luckily, Herman recorded the games, and the team ended up winning without me, so it looks like I wasn't even needed.
Should I be waiting? Feels like I have too much of drama, but I'm not ready to give in. We'll be right back.
gonna give a little bit of a commentary here because what happens is a little bit funky. So the team is playing BCIT and Josh just absolutely rocks this girl with a ball straight to the face. Bap! Obviously not on purpose, but they had to stop the game because of it. Everything ended up being okay in the end, and both teams are ready to continue playing. But look at this woman here scream like a Karen for no reason. Absolutely no idea what this girl's problem is. Apparently she's on the organizing committee for athletics. And then after the tournament, she called Josh out for having too much toxic masculinity. What? Anyways, none of this even mattered because we ended up beating them handily, so. Last play of this game, it's 5-on-5, but our team gets 4 in a row, back-to-back, to back-to-back, and it's now 5v1. She tries to throw at Herman, Herman catches the ball, and Josh sends her absolutely freaking flying just for good measure. I am so proud of the team for winning West Coast Games, and I think they went undefeated, which is absolutely insane. We are so ready to take on any team that comes our way, whether it be British Columbia, Manitoba, Alberta, anyone. I'm so excited for competition weekend. But that is going to wrap up part number 3 of the JDC West journey. But before we end this video, I want to show you a few miscellaneous clips first. And as promised, we have Kenny wearing split shorts because we beat his fundraising goal. So here is him wearing split shorts trying to sell tickets at a charity event.
Bro.
I took a box of my shorts.
50 tickets? Is that what we're talking about?
Not really. Oh my gosh.
Could be anything.
Cheese!
What else are we selling?
Not your body.
So you speak, Eva.
Look at this guy's legs.
What about my legs?
Just an attractive looking guy.
Volleyball Intramurals, I think we got knocked out because we couldn't field a team on such short notice. UBC Intramural Organizing Committee is a little disorganized, so we got notified we had a game like a few hours before it happened, so we were unable to make it. But here's a video of us getting absolutely destroyed in Dodgeball Intramurals, like 14-1, but at least Carson ended it off on a good note.
He has all the balls.
Attaboy, Carson.
Yeah! Good job,
yeah,
guys.
I won the last one.
Yay.
Good job. Good
job. And lastly, we had our Christmas social with the big team, and it was so fun. We did Secret Santa, and Caitlin received a penis from Charles.
What? Why do you all do this?
One ball and skit, guys. Yeah.
Oh, that's a breathing.
Yo, Eric went out here and he made me food. This guy made me food. He also got me some coupons for some stickers from Kelly, plus potato salad, a cookie, and chicken parmesan. This guy made me food. I love him so much. Oh, sorry.
Matt,
sorry, I'm trying to take a video. Oh, do you want me to hold it?
Yeah, he's got elbows.
I know, that's really
funny. Matt.
You know what? I think I'll pass, Josh. What sort of soup is it?
Sour soup?
I can't open it. It's literally sour cream. This guy's trying to feed me some sour cream.
No, it's my favorite.
This guy's eating cream on more cream, bro. Just straight dairy.
Dairy farmers hate it.
No, dairy, but I'm a dairy farmer.
But that's gonna wrap it up for part number 3 of the JDC West saga. We're ramping down all of our activities right now because we're about to do our exam season as well as a go on Christmas break. So I'm about to head back to Toronto, but low key, COVID is coming in pretty hard right now. A few of our exams got moved online and things aren't looking good. We're hitting like our 5th wave or something crazy. So hopefully the competition will still happen. Competition weekend slated for January 15th. So we still got a ton more time left, but we just really hope that it's not gonna get canceled. But I think all of us are just a little bit scared right now, especially the athletics team, because we really don't know what's gonna happen if it does get canceled. Obviously, you can't do athletics online, so that would be a major bummer, especially for me, because I didn't get to play in the West Coast game. So this would be my only chance to play with the team, which is really sad to say. But we're just gonna cross our fingers, hope that the competition still happens, and pray for the best. So thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see you guys in the new year. Welcome back to the JDC West video series. If you didn't catch the first part of this video, go check down below in the video description where it'll be linked, where we went over all of our team practices as well as our team socials and us completing our community volunteer hours as well as us raising money for charity. But this video is going to be all about the grand finale. It's going to be competition weekend, or in this case, lack of competition weekend. See, as you can tell, I'm back home in Markham, Ontario because of COVID. And because of COVID, we're not going to be having our competition. And unfortunately, the organizing committee announced that everything's going to be completely online. But how is the athletics team going to participate if it's online, you may ask? Well, I have even worse news. They decided that the athletics team is going to be participating in Rocket League. Oh my gosh, bro. Rocket League. Bro, I'm going to call up my younger brother and say, hey dude, can you play Rocket League? Dude, I have no idea how to play Rocket League, man. I'm too old for this. I can't do Rocket League. But it is what it is, and I'm gonna feel so bad if we pull out because the whole big team is depending on us to do the athletic stuff. But I think even worse than the fact that we have to play Rocket League is the fact that we're not even playing volleyball anymore. I mean, all that time and effort that we spent into practicing volleyball and having our coaches be there at our tournaments and our practices and getting gym time, all for it to be for nothing, like, it just absolutely blows my mind and I am so sad. My sadness is immeasurable and my day is ruined.
My disappointment is immeasurable and my day is ruined.
Like, why can't the organizing committee just postpone the event, like, maybe a month? COVID's going down, but all that is maybe just talk for another day, but Honestly, I'm just so disappointed. I even get to play in the West Coast games. That's so upsetting to me. I didn't even get to play with the team. But anyways, we're like a week and a few days out from the tournament, so we have time to get our practice in and hopefully find some team chemistry in this new sport, and hopefully we do good. So obviously it sucks, but we're gonna try our best, and we're gonna try our best to have fun, because that's the whole reason I signed up for JDC West. So wish us luck, because we're gonna need it. Hey guys, this is Matt from the future. I just wanted to preface this entire video by saying I hate it. I hate how JDC West handled the situation. I hated playing Rocket League. I hated making this video. I hated editing this video. And I hate having to publish this video because this video absolutely sucks. But I feel like it was only right to have a full complete saga for the viewer, so this is that video. And right now you're seeing Rocket League footage. If you haven't seen Rocket League before, this is what it is. You basically just control a car and try to punt a ball into a net. But we recorded close to 10 hours of gameplay footage between our practices as well as the actual competition weekend. But I swear, if I have to look through any more Rocket League footage, I'm probably gonna, yeah. So most of this video is just gonna be me talking about what happened instead of showing any actual Rocket League footage. So yeah, this is all you're gonna get. But anyways, I'm so sorry in advance that this video absolutely sucks. Blame it on the organizing committee.
It all started about 1,000 years ago, back in the Stone Age, where we first documented the first sighting of the human advantage. We were primitive creatures, yes, but the human advantage was in our blood, in our DNA. We learned to give and care for each other altruistically. But war broke out, and then we needed to select the finest warriors.
Get out! Now!
Warriors lost their lives through valiant acts of bravery.
Oh, I love how my hair feels in this wind.
Get them!
Goodbye, Tom.
Oh no, my beautiful hair!
It seemed that power was the one thing that people wanted the most. They never seemed to get enough of it. But some found solace, you see, in creating new inventions, empowered by the human advantage. Investment came along and saw a problem and gave them money. It was only a matter of time for that investment to allow for growth in the technological sector. Here, advance technological advancements that provided the human species with the ultimate human advantage. It was the creation of Dogecoin. This is what provided humanity with the ultimate human advantage. When Dogecoin became the world reserve currency, and just like that, everyone became rich overnight. But we still needed accountants. Throughout it all, we always had the human advantage.
Okay, so we played our first three games. It's lunch break now. Doing pretty decently, I guess. We are 2-1. We won our first two, lost the last one. Sort of got smoked, but it's okay. And then on the other side with the other athletics team, I think they're 0-3. But that's okay, they're having fun. Or at least I hope they're having fun. They're probably not having fun, but we're doing it for Sauder. So let's go have some lunch and then we can hopefully come back replenished and ready to win. Day number one of competition is complete. I have to say, today was such a freaking weird thing, but it's okay. We placed 5th overall out of 12 teams, although there's 12 schools, but only like 7 teams for athletics because some of them didn't put together a team. But that's besides the point. 5th place, not bad. But there are also other funny memes. One of the commentators for one of like the live streams, when we were live streaming, made a joke about having STDs or something. I wasn't there. I didn't hear it. But come on, man. This is JDC. They don't even allow us to swear. But and then also OC. OC has no idea what they're doing. There's so many mess ups. So yeah, what a not great day. Maybe I'm just salty because we're bad at Rocket League, but yeah. Anyways, we have meetings tonight for JDC Big Team, and then sleep time, and then we do it all tomorrow, except we're playing Rocket League Hoops, so hopefully we'll be better. So it's day number 2 of competition, today we're playing Hoops. This one should be a good one. It's so random, and I swear this entire game mode is all about luck, but for our other team that's playing, we have one of our academic subs, Chillin, stepping in. So, God bless you, Chillin. Hopefully he helps us do well. And so, yeah, super excited to get the day started and play Hoops. So, we just finished up all of our round robin games, and we did pretty well. I think our team did pretty well, and then as well as Chillin and the other side did also super well. So, I think we actually came in 2nd place for the round robin. So that means we're going to have an easier game. I think we play the 7th place team, which is going to be an easy clap. And then we're off to quarters, semis, and then we're off to the finals. So, yes. And I think Chillin's probably going to come in and take me out for the playoffs. So we should be doing really well. We should have some easy games coming up because we're 2nd and we're going to play the 7th place team. Alright, so we just faced University of Alberta in the quarters and University of Manitoba in the semis. And oh my gosh, Chillin actually went off. The guy's actually a god. Thank gosh for him carrying our team. And now we're off to the finals against University of Calgary. University of Calgary won yesterday's competition. Like, they went all the way and won it. So hopefully, gonna be a pretty good match. And hopefully we'll come out with a win. So that's it. We lost to the University of Calgary in the finals, but we put up a great effort. You know, Chillin actually went off. This guy's actually a god. But the other team was just a little bit better, and all three of them were pretty good. So it is what it is. Overall, had fun. And so that's it. JDC competition complete. Now I think we have some Gala Night stuff after and some fun stuff. So yeah, we're having a big team meeting right now. We're going to take our final pictures. And also, we shot a little video for our captains, just a big thank you video from all the teams. It's like 30 minutes long, so I can't put the entire thing in this video. But I'll show you the athletics video right here.
Thank you, captain.
Lydia.
And
Zach.
For
being the
best
co-captains ever.
You
are
amazing
and
really
fun. And
very
excellent
dancers.
We
are
so grateful
for
everything
you
done
for
us and
thank
you
for
being
our
captains. Yay!
Hey, Zach and Lydia. So unfortunately, I was grocery shopping when the rest of the athletics team did their thank you video, but I just want to say thank you so much for everything you've done for me this year. You've honestly made this an amazing experience for me, and I couldn't be more thankful.
So thank you so much to the captains and the executives for all that you've done. Of course, this isn't the JDC competition that we want to have because we're online, but they did so much work to make it happen and just to make the quick pivot to being online. So thank you so much, Zach and Lydia. We couldn't have done this without you. So yeah, we're going to go off. We took our group picture, so I'll show that here as well. We're also going to go to our gala night and closing ceremonies and see our awards for the team. And just like that, competition weekend is over. Last night we had our final big team meeting, and then we went straight into gala night and awards night. And oh my gosh, during awards night, they just called on Sauder so many freaking times. Sauder just went absolutely off. It was actually crazy. I have a list of all the things that we accomplished, so let me just read it to you real quick. So athletics, we came third place. Oh, if I didn't explain it in the video earlier, we came fifth and then second in the 2 days of athletics, but then I believe Hill also became second and fifth in like opposite days to us, but then they beat us in the tiebreaker, so they got second place overall and we got third. Unfortunate, but hey, third place isn't too bad, so third place for athletics, pretty cool. Also, we got third place for our intro video, which I showed earlier. I believe they just voted for the captains which intro video is best, and we got third, so that's pretty cool too. Alright, for second place, we came second place in entrepreneurship, second place in not-for-profit, and second place in challenge, so that's pretty cool, as well as second place in charity dollars raised. So shout out Carissa, that was all Carissa. And then first place, oh my gosh, so many. We came first place in operations, first place in international business, first place in business tech management, first place in accounting. Oh, and also we came first place in participation for the first time in 12 years. Sauder got first place in participation. Mostly because people say Sauder has maybe a little bit of a stereotype for not being such great sports, but it's all good because we broke that stereotype this weekend and we got first place in participation. Our team went off with the memes in the Discord channel, and I guess the organizing committee noticed, and they're like, these guys are participating so much with the memes, first place. So we secured first place for participation. How awesome. First time in 12 years. And then the big ones, first place in academic school of the year. I believe this is the first time in a few years. And last but not least, first place school of the year. This is the first time in 6 years that Sauder has been school of the year. How crazy is that? But the fun does not stop there. While we were celebrating in our Zoom call after the awards ceremony, some people from UVic decided to send some memes to the Discord where like everyone can see it. And oh wow, these memes are so fun. I'm gonna put them on screen right now. Placing third in playoffs, UVic, round robins. Wait, this one's even better. Athletic teams using their esports players all weekend and JDC not catching them. Oh my gosh, wait, there's one more. JDC figuring out a way to fuck UVic. And they sent this to everyone, and even the organizing committee saw this as well. Although, I can understand their frustration. Talking with the other athletic teams, we were all just sort of getting the vibe. It was like, disappointed but not surprised. Or like, damn, our expectations were low, but we knew it was going to be a complete hot mess walking into this weekend, but wow, we were blown away. But I guess on the bright side, that's something that we bonded with other teams over, our mutual disdain for how JDC West Athletics went. And so that concludes the JDC West competition experience, all wrapped up, finally coming to a close. I'm sorry if my tone was a little bit all over the place this video. Your boy was a little bit upsetty spaghetti that we weren't playing volleyball or dodgeball, and I would have to film myself playing Rocket League. Rocket League of all things. But hey, we got school of the year, and that's all that matters. Once again, huge shout out to our captains, our execs, our sponsors, our coaches, and everyone else that made this possible and cheered us on from the beginning. And thank you so much for watching. Hope to see you guys in the next one. Cheers.
I guess I'll go ahead.
Hi guys, welcome to my OnlyFans. We're gonna make some exclusive content here today. I think Sean wants to join me. It's gonna be kinky. Matt's not invited. Matt's done enough.
This is something we spent way too much time working on instead of all of our other assignments. But to send off, now that you've had your trophies and pictures, we wanted to give some extra special awards. Look at this quality right here. It's very quality. To honor the things that you guys have achieved over the course of the year outside of just the competition itself. So a very select few awards that we will announce in a sec. If you get an award, come to the front and we will crown you with this amazing quality medal. $25 on Amazon, what a steal.
You paid $25? That's so much.
This is the Chad and or Brad Award for Best Debater Against the CUS. And the winner is...
Wow.
We have most likely to shoot a gopher award. This, of course, is gonna go to anyone.
Is that for me?
How did you kill so many gophers? Wow.
The marketing competitor award, who else did it?
You know, this entire time I thought Kelly was in the marketing specialization. Josh Lax. Josh Lax. Oh, thank you.
Only next year.
Oh, sorry.
Okay. Just Leia convinced me. And I'm so glad. This is honestly like one of the greatest experiences of my life. Just getting to meet all you guys and, you know, go and do fun stuff like retreat. And even though we couldn't gather together in Winnipeg, like the fact that we were able to win for the first time in 6 years, the fact that we're able to be so close together, like I know we'll be close for years and years and years to come, hopefully a lifetime. This has been the most unbelievable journey I've ever experienced, and like, you guys made that happen. It is thanks to you that we are all together. It is thanks to you that we're able to win, and I really hope that all of you in some capacity stick around for next year, because JDC moves on to the next Ogre province of Saskatchewan. Very exciting stuff.
And speaking of next year, we're excited to in person, the 2023 cap.
And also
also there's a special
Chillin Wu serenading Lydia.
The song is Hey There Delilah.
Hey there, Lydia.
Hey there, Lydia, what's it like in New York City? I'm a thousand miles away, but girl, tonight you look so pretty, yes you do. Sometimes we're concerned, but it's you, I say it's true. Hey there, Lydia, don't you worry about the distance. I'm right there if you get lonely, give this song another listen. Close your eyes. Listen to my voice, it's my disguise. I'm not a disguise. Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 Can you find the lyrics? I know times are getting hotter. Just believe me, girl, someday I'll pay the bills with this guitar and we'll have it all. We'll have the life we knew we would. Power is good. Hey there, Lydia, I got so much left to say. Every simple song I wrote to you would take your breath away. I'd write it all. Even more in love. Oh, it's what you do to me. 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 A thousand miles seems pretty far, but they've got planes and trains and cars. I'd walk to you if I had no other way. Our friends would all make fun of us, and we'll just laugh along because we know that none of them have felt this way. Lydia, I can promise you that by the time that we get through, the world will never ever be the same, and you're to blame. Hey there, Lydia, and we all just make history like we do. You'll know it's all because of you. We can do whatever we want to. Hey there, Lydia, these two. This one's for you.
Love you.